Good morning to all of you. In the previous class, we have already discussed about the different types of chemical reaction. Today, we shall discuss about the general organic reaction. So, in general organic reaction, the organic molecules reacts with reagent to form product. So today we shall discuss about the organic reagent. That organic reagent always attack on the organic molecules during the chemical reaction to form product. So now it is essential to know about the reagent. How can you define a reagent? So reagent, it is a substance or compounds which is added to a system to cause a chemical reaction is called reagent. So without reagent, there is no possibility to proceeding the any chemical reaction. So now we shall discuss about the types of reagent. So there are two types of reagent. First is your electrophiles and second is your nucleophiles. Electrophiles is represented by E positive charge and nucleophiles is represented like this, Nu consisting of negative charge. So now, what is electrophiles? The word electrophiles is made up by two words, electro and philes. The meaning of electro means electron and phile means lover. So generally electrophiles is an electron deficient reagent which always attack on the electron rich or electron donor reagent. For example, chlorine cations and methyl cations. Chlorine cations and methyl cations. So generally we can represent an electrophiles like this, E plus, and electrophiles always attack on the electron rich reagent like this. Now we shall discuss about the neutral electrophiles. Positive electrophiles. Now we shall discuss about at first positive electrophile. For example, chlorine cation, methyl cation, NO2 plus, and Br plus. All these are electrophiles, and all these are also known as positive electrophiles due to the presence of positive charge on each reagent. Now, how the formation of chlorine cations and how the formation of chlorine cations takes place. So at first, when the bond cleavage takes place between two chlorine atoms in the presence of UV light, in the presence of UV light, the formation of chlorine free radicals takes place like this. And during the bond cleavage, the bonding electron from both chlorine atom migrate itself like this. After then, the formation of chlorine free radicals takes place. And after the oxidation of chlorine free radicals, the formation of chlorine cation takes place. It happens by the oxidation, by the oxidation of chlorine free radical. Free radicals. So now the formation of chlorine cation takes place by the oxidation of chlorine free radicals in second case, and the bond cleavage takes place between two chlorine atom. That bond cleavage is also known as that bond cleavage is also known as homolytic bond cleavage. In second case, in the case of CH3 cation, when we draw the structure of methyl cation like this, the structure of methyl cation is like this, and there are three covalent bonds are present between carbon and three hydrogen atom in methyl cation. Therefore, the total number of electrons present on the carbon atom. Therefore, the total number of electrons are present. Three covalent bonds, the total number of electrons are present on the carbon atom is 6, but for getting the stability of carbon atom, it required two more electrons. Hence, CH3 methyl cation is an electron deficient reagent. Now, second electrophiles is your neutral electrophiles. This electrophiles is also known as no charge, consisting electrophiles. It means in the case of neutral electrophiles, there is no any charge on that compounds. For example, BF3, boron trifluoride, and CO2, carbon dioxide compounds. So at first, we shall draw the structure of carbon dioxide compounds. The structure of carbon dioxide compounds. CO2. So now, at first draw the structure of carbon dioxide. There are 4 valence electrons are present on the carbon atom, and 2 oxygen atoms are attached with the central carbon atom by sharing 2 electrons like this. So the formation of 2 covalent bond takes place between carbon and 2 oxygen in carbon dioxide compounds. So in this way, the octet of carbon atom is completed, because there are four covalent bonds are present in CO2 molecules. The eight electrons are present on the
carbon atom, and the carbon atom, but due to the more electronegative of oxygen, the bonding electron from carbon atom pulled by both oxygen atom, and finally the electron deficiency shows on the carbon atom. Finally, electron deficiency shows on the carbon atom. Therefore,
we can say that carbon dioxide molecules is also a neutral electrophile. And now we shall discuss about the structure of Bf3. The structure of Bf3 in atom. In the case of Bf3 molecules, at first we shall draw the structure of boron trifluoride. Boron trifluoride. Boron trifluoride. Bf3. And this is the p orbitals of boron. So in Bf3 molecules, there are three covalent bonds. Therefore, the total number of bonding electrons on boron atom is 6. 6 electrons. Boron atom, 6 electrons. But due to the vacant p orbitals in the case of boron atom in Bf3 compounds, it needs two more electrons, or simply you can say that boron needs two more electrons for getting the stability. That's why we can say that Bf3 is also an electron deficient compound, but there is no any charge assigned on the Bf3 molecules as well as CO2 molecules. Therefore, but both molecules having tendency to show the electron deficiency. That's why we can say that such types of electrophiles are neutral electrophiles, because due to the absence of charge on such types of molecules. That's all. In next class, we shall discuss about the nucleophiles.